Hello, my Capricorns, Cappies. I hope you guys are doing wonderful. So I had somebody ask me, I got my little white hair sticking out. I had somebody ask me about doing love readings for the month. Normally, I do not do them, and some people are going to say because I have a black heart, but I do not. But I figured, you know what? Maybe I should do love. Let's do love. Let's see what's going on. Let's open this door up. Let some air into my heart. So we're going to see, Capricorns, what's going on for you this month in August. Let's see. All right. So. Ooh, soulmate connection too. Lord, help y'all. Help the Capricorns. Okay, so the first card is staying optimistic about your love life. Now, for some of you, especially right next to unrequited love, some of you may have a crush, be in love, have love feelings, dream about love with somebody that's close to you, but you may feel like it's not reciprocated. This could be a friendship. Not every love is romantic love, but I feel for some of you, you want it to be more romantic. But it's showing that even though this relationship has playful aspects to it, and you may enjoy doing things with this person, that there's not a strong love connection. So for some of you, I do feel like you're very hopeful. And you feel like if I put the time in it, this person is going to open up. And anything is possible. Unrequited love, to me, is not a forever thing with a person. I have seen this with people that I read for, where maybe at the beginning of the month, they don't love you. And at the end of the year, they've grown to love you, or the love feelings have come. Now, be mindful with that. If the person is giving you signs that they are willing to entertain growing something with you, then put your energy into it. But if the person is absolutely sure that they don't want to grow anything with you, then you got to back off. Don't stalk. Don't become a stalker. Because for some of you, I do see this is going to happen. You're going to be watching this person on Facebook, Instagram. What are they doing? Are they dating somebody else? What's going on with them? You know, we should be together. Don't torture yourself like that. If it's supposed to open up, it will. But if it doesn't within a time limit, then you got to step back. Focus more on yourself, or focus on this new love that's going to be coming your way too. Now, for some of you, I do see you having a person or a friend or a connection that there is definitely a playfulness to it. They bring out your youth. They bring out your fun, your fun factor. And for some of you, you feel like this is what you want, because maybe life has been slow. Things haven't been really popping lately. And this person makes you laugh. They make you feel good, or vice versa. General reading, this could go either way. So for some of you, I definitely feel like there's a playful aspect to a relationship. May not be completely romantic, but it brings out something in you that you like, you enjoy, and you're not ready to cut that off yet. I do see for some of you, you're not really sure. You're not sure if you really want to be deeply in love with somebody or if you want to be single. So you're kind of like in this middle ground where it's like, you know, I have friends, I'm dating, I'm putting myself out there, but I haven't really made the decision to go full steam ahead into a relationship. That's fine. Take your time. That's what dating is. Go out, have coffee. Have a drink, go to the movies, enjoy the person. And if it develops, go with the flow. If it doesn't, and you feel like, okay, we're just going to be friend zone, that's what it is. But for some of you, I feel like you're not really mentally or emotionally ready for a relationship. And if you're not, don't force it. Don't push it. It will come in the right time. Not everybody that we get with needs to be our love partner. So take your time with that. Now, for some of you, I feel like you're finding your courage or your second wind. Some of you want to flirt. It may be out of your element. Maybe you haven't flirted in a while, but you're looking for a soulmate connection. You're looking to meet that new love. So some of you have just come to the realization, I ain't going to meet nobody if I don't come out the house. unless you're doing online dating. But for some of you, I feel like you need to come out. And I think this was even in your reading for the month, that some of you need to come out your bubble. Put yourself out there. Actually go to events. Dance. You know, go to a hibachi grill. You know, watch them chop up some food. Do some tricks in front of you. Some of you need to put yourself out there in front of people so you can make a connection. Now, I do see for some of you that are coming out of this bubble, there is a love connection. There's a soulmate connection. And it could be romantic. It feels like it's something familiar. Some of you are going to meet somebody that you're just like, wow, I've connected with you before. I know it. I feel it. You know, we've shared something together. You're looking at certain movies and it's like, I feel the same way about this movie that you did. We're on the same page. Or even the food. You like the same food that I like. So for some of you, you definitely are connecting with a soulmate vibe. Now, it is showing taking your time to get to know this person. Some of you, when you meet the soulmate, you may not still be in that mindset of, I want a relationship. Some of you are going to meet this person and still be like, I feel the connection, but I want a date. Do it. If that's what you feel like you want to do, do it, because it says getting to know the person, which means you're going to take your time. For some of you, you are going to meet a new person, but it's still going to be some person from your past that's pulling on your heartstrings. This new person, there's so many things in common that you have with them. You feel good with them, but you're like, oh, but they're not Michael, but they're not Susan. They're just not. Don't get caught up in that. For some of you, you may need to release the past. Now, I do see for a few of you, you're going to meet somebody and then bam, here comes this past lover. I want you back. I didn't realize what I had until you was gone. Now I want you back, baby. Come be with me. And you're kind of like, damn, you know, do I give this relationship a chance? Or do I connect with the soulmate? What do I do? Some of you, you're going to be confused as hell. It comes down to a choice between two people. Somebody from your future, somebody from your past. Now, with this, because I do feel like with soulmate connections, of course, it's a past life connection with karmic ties. You may feel like you're pulled towards your soulmate. I do feel for some of you, you're caught up on how the person from your past makes you feel. And maybe the soulmate relationship hasn't developed to that level yet. Or maybe you're still going through some karmic stuff with this soulmate that you don't see the outcome of that. Now, it is saying that some of you, you're going to turn your back on the past and you're going to move towards this new person. And it's because even though that person from the past made you laugh and smile and everything, there's a deeper connection with the soulmate. There's romantic feelings. It's not superficial. It's deeper. And for some of you, you really want that connection. Now, for a few of you, you don't want to go through the karmic ties with a soulmate. You know, you like them. You're getting to know them and everything. And you're like, you're cool. You like the same stuff I like. You listen to the same music I listen to. You know, we like the same color. But I want to give somebody, I want to go back and give somebody else a chance. I'm not done with them yet. I'm not done. And that's okay. That's okay, Capricorns. If it happens, you got to go back and revisit, close that door the proper way if that's what you need. For those who have shut the door on the past and you know for sure you don't want to move forward with this person, you're going to move towards this soulmate because you've been praying for this person. You've been calling this person in. And for some of you, you just going back to the past has no, there's nothing there for you. So you want to move forward. So I do feel for some of you, you're definitely opening yourself up to meeting somebody new, having deeper feelings, deeper connections. You don't want just superficial. You want something a little bit more meaningful. You're not trying to date 15 people to see how it feels or what you're going to get out of it. You really are looking for that one person that really gets you and has that connection with you. And for some of you, you are going to find it. You are going to find it. For a few of you that go back to the past, I'm not going to say that it can't last because I do see you putting in a lot of effort. But I do always tell people sometimes you got to remember why they're the ex, why they're in the past. It doesn't mean that you can't revisit it. But if you revisit it and you see some of the same behavior that made you walk away in the first place, then you might need to go ahead and close that door and move towards something brand new. And for some of you, you definitely are. You're going to find a brand new love. You're going to find a brand new connection. I don't see it ending up in marriage right now, but I definitely see two people that are taking the chance to explore, getting to know each other, flirting, developing romantic feelings, spending some time together because they want that same type of connection. Take your time. Like I tell everybody, take your time. There's no rush, especially when it comes to love. When it comes to love, you don't want to move too fast. You want to see it in every aspect. The good, the bad, the ugly, the good when you get there. So definitely take your time, you guys. Mwah. Love you.